Okay, we're going to have a very short business meeting before we begin the traditions. And Janine has her treasurer's report.
That's me. I don't like this. My name is Janine, I'm an Aquali. Last month, the balance was $398.46. Okay, we paid the rent in December. $50 to intergroup, $50 to general service like the meeting asks. The cake for Tom last week was $15. Collection last week was $43. So we have, with the rent, and we have coffee for the month?
So far.
So far, okay. We have coffee for the month. We have a balance of $238.26. Any comment?
You probably need coffee for the month of December.
Okay, I'll buy coffee. Buy coffee, I'm gonna buy my Dion.
Are you reimbursing yourself for the food you're bringing in?
No, that's okay for this time. Well, that's Christmas present.
Okay. You're certainly entitled to it if you want to.
Yeah, I know, but I did not do it.
It's a very important part of the meeting.
I just have a question. When I had gone to the GSR meeting, I introduced myself in, our meeting, and they had asked me, would I be a part of the GSR meeting that takes place in January? I didn't have any information on it.
Where will that be?
I think it's Orlando.
Orlando?
Didn't have any information on what? On the meeting?
Yeah, I didn't have any information on how, because I've never done this before, on do I go, how do I go, because they were talking that
would
I
you like to go? We have enough money to send you. It's up to the group if you want to go.
Okay, well, what I'll do is I'll get all the information from, I'll call my district person.
Okay.
You do have a conflict in your schedule. Can you go?
Now, how are you going to go there?
I can drive. I mean...
Oh, yeah, we're going to pay your gas and your rent?
Well, let me get the information and then I'll bring it back to you.
Okay.
I'll call them tomorrow.
Okay. Is that okay with the group?
Yes.
Good.
That's why we have a
trip.
That's why we have a GSR.
Okay. Now, how about the intergroup service?
I'm Kathy, I'm an alcoholic.
Okay.
I finally went to the intergroup meeting. This is my first time also, so I took some notes and I brought the information home that they gave me. They had indicated that donations were down last month by $1,600 for I guess what all came in for the county. One thing they did say that Palmco Work Release Program needs speakers, and they need institution speakers, basically. So if you're interested, they're hoping people will volunteer. And then they had a few arguments, and that for the first time, that was it. They also desperately need help with the phone relay system, they indicated. And then, I don't know what we want to do with this stuff. There's an announcement for the Christmas dance. The Winterfest dance is December 15th from 9 p.m. to 12 a.m. There's a group that changed their meeting location. And there's an anniversary dinner at the 12-step house on December 1st, which would be
Hey Kathy, is it somebody to answer the phone at intergroup? Is that what you need?
What?
Somebody to answer the phone at intergroup?
Yeah, I've got a little flyer that they gave us on it. What do we need? One relay volunteer coordinator for your group. Four willing volunteers. Then we need to determine which week, month, and all that. We'll do it. And there's a phone number for us to call. Because basically, I guess they want each group to help and participate.
Right.
Because if there's no one to answer the phones, it switches over to an answering service. Which in turn brought up a big discussion about when you call, if you get the answer, service, it says that for quality assurance, this message may be recorded. And some people were very uncomfortable with that. And obviously, the group consensus seemed to be two things. It got a little confusing after a while, but one, that it's a phone to command all the time, you wouldn't have to worry about an answering service, period. Therefore, eliminating that problem. They seem to be concerned about confidentiality and anonymity. Mm-hmm. And by law, they have to say if they're recording it. Mm-hmm. And if you're leaving a message, obviously you're being recorded.
Right.
So they kind of left it at, which made no sense to me, as like I said, that we'll just tell them not to say that anymore. We're still being recorded. And I think the bottom line comes down to if there were enough people, this wouldn't be an issue, and every alcoholic that calls would get the help they need.
Just a question, Kathy. Did they state how much time one has to have to be a phone relay person?
We don't worry about stuff like that.
Yeah, more than a day. No.
You know, it's like one day a week. If you're interested to volunteer, I can call them if you want to go.
Yeah, I'm saying, so they don't have a time on.
I think there might have been. I mean, to tell you the truth, I'm supposed to be on something. I've never gotten a call in 2 years, but I was put on it like the first month I was in, you know, in the program. I've never gotten a phone call. I think this is a little more intense. But
well, I think what we ought to do is authorize Janine and our and our intergroup rep. Wait a minute now. You're as bad as I. to select a coordinator. And the coordinator can select four people, and then Janine can notify intergroup as to who is working from our group. You'll be able to find people who are willing to do it, right?
If we have somebody in the group who are interested, how many people who want to go?
Well, you may just have to ask around.
Okay.
Tom? Interested in what?
I think
go at intergroup and. You know, like somebody call over there, they're alcoholic and they want to know where meeting is.
So we have the phones.
It's the AA hotline.
I don't think that that's the way it works, does it? Because I think that it's a relay, so the call gets transforwarded to your phone.
To your house.
Yeah,
we
you
have that also.
If it's your night, you need to be near your phone.
Right.
You're obligated.
We
you're
have
committed
to
I don't think they physically want you to go to interview.
They no, they don't.
Relay the call to you, right?
Right. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Phone relay.
No, I
said
you had to go there.
We'll get the number.
Yeah, if we're interested, we'll find
I'm going Monday at the interview. I'll ask them and I'll tell you next week.
Okay.
Okay. Now, the support for AA. General Service Office Group. Do you have the number of the group? We have a number. And the GSR have to have the number.
That you send, when you send
money. When you send money, we have a number.
Yeah.
Can I have the number, please? If you have the right number?
Not right now.
Oh, okay. But will you write it down?
I'll call you.
Okay.
Tonight, I'll give it to you.
No, my husband's, I don't want to wake him
up.
I'll give it to you later.
Okay.
Okay, now to support for AA, we see 50-50 the last month, but usually 60% to intergroup, 30% to general service, but I give half and half, and 10% to the area committee for institution, if somebody want to volunteer. I'll say we'll give 40% to GSR according to the group conscience. If you want to give more for you to go to Orlando, it's up to the group conscience.
I don't understand what your question is.
Okay, well, if you look in the literature,
what are you trying to say?
Well, I'm saying last month when we did the business meeting, we see half here and half there. It's supposed to be 60 to intergroup. But the balance of the money we have, instead of 50 there, we're supposed to give 60% of intergroup.
Okay.
Plus 30 to general service. Plus 10% for the committee, since we don't have any committee. But GSR, according to the group conscious, it's supposed to be 40, but we can give more if she needs more to go to Orlando or wherever.
Well, I think what we have to do is find out first what our responsibility is going to be for a trip to Orlando. Then we can decide what money is left over to send to GSR in New York. We don't, there's no requirement that we send any money whatsoever to institutions. That's not any part of it. The 60-40 or 60-30-10 is suggested, but it does not bind the group in any way. We can make up our own minds how we want to distribute the money. But don't you think it'd be a good idea to wait to see how much there is left over after her Orlando trip before we decide what we're going to donate this month?
Oh, we'll have a lot left. Because we already got 238.26, and we still have a month. So we can go up to 500 easy.
Well, let's.
I have to buy the medallion, though. We got three.
Well, let's.
37 years. Can we buy him a medallion? They have one for $15, a special one. Can we use the money from the group?
Sure, we can. Sure.
Okay. Yeah. So we'll give him a special one because it's so special. It's a blue one.
Good.
So Monday I have to order it.
I motion if we pass that second.
It's really nice.
I second the motion.
Good. Okay, he deserves it. Eh?
Good.
And anything else? Anybody has a question or?
Yes. It's all about the dance. So are we done with this?
Right. There you go.
Tom, why don't you tell us what we need to do now?
Okay. First of all, with the dance. The board has approved the fact that by having dances, or a dance, as of this Saturday, and on a tentative basis. One of the keys to this so far has always been that there's a board member at every dance. Now, they're quite pleased with the idea that we're going to give. Now, my understanding is that all the collections are given to the 101 Club, meaning all the extra monies that we make, right? So far, my understanding is the donation at the door will be $3, correct?
$2.
Correct.
$3.
$3.
$3.
$3. Last week was $2.
No, it was $3 from my notes. But, okay. Anyways, $3 is the going rate. Does that sound fair to everyone?
Yes, that's very
okay,
good.
Okay, $3 is good. The next thing is that the board member has to be there, and then as far as cleaning up and setting up, and with regard to this, are we going to have Coke? If so, we must purchase it. So I will need money from that because we can go directly to my stash back here, but we need to, do we want Coca-Cola and stuff like that at the dance?
Yeah.
Yeah. We also need ice. Okay, and if there's anybody with any other brilliant ideas about food, whatever, it need be brought up now.
How much do you need, Tom?
I'm asking first before I know. Very simply, what I will do is just give you how much it is and then pay for it. So that's, if we have a carte blanche, that's what I normally do with the dances, is I just take out three cases of Coke, three cases of Diet, two cases of regular Coke, etc., which is about $5.75 a case. What's left, we just kick back to the group, to the thing, and then we're done. So you're going to have ice expenditure. Are we getting a charge for the DJ? Are we giving the DJ anything this first time?
No.
Are we giving the DJ any time?
I offered it. He doesn't want it.
Okay. The most important thing about that is that if the DJ, as far as I'm concerned, if the DJ does not take money, I think we need to do something nice for him.
What's a DJ?
DJ, the guy who plays the music.
The disc jockey.
So even if he doesn't take the money, it would be nice that he was either recognized or we did something nice in Christmas for him or something
right.
like that. Such a suggestion. I am.
We'll give him a big round of applause.
Right. Okay. All right. He doesn't want it, so that's because they asked me about that, how much the DJ would cost, etc. Because dances down the way, there may be a cost factor.
Yeah, down the way.
Right.
I know you're right.
Okay. So, well, then again, what I'm trying to say is, money-wise, that's the only expenditure I can see. The only other thing is they will be very watchful each and every week about how the club is cleaned up afterwards. So if, how many here plan on being here at 1 o'clock in the morning for this dance? Because the guy who said he's going to clean up, who's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's more than enough to do the little stuff that's done, if you're going to be here. Okay, now Gary is the one who's supposedly in charge, and he's not here. So that means that Gary is, you know, yes?
Tom, what does the cleanup entail?
All it does is very simply put these chairs and everything back in order. So we take these out so they can dance, push them aside, they've got to be back because they have a breakfast in the morning. That's really all there is to it. I do all the other cleanup.
Okay, so that's
it. It's not mopping floors or anything like that. Okay. It's more about, you know, making sure. Just getting a chair and stuff so that someone doesn't start ripping their flapper at us about leaving the place a mess.
Okay.
You know, so that's just, so if we have that many people, that's, and everybody knows who they are, so as far as, because I mean, if you're going, you're not going to be here, that's fine. If the following week, we can do more people. But the dance is set up from 10:30 to 1? Is that what we have? Is that what?
Well, soon after 10 as we can get organized,
okay.
Yeah.
So 10 to 1, and if it's a dud, we can just close early. If it's not,
sure,
we can go later.
Sure.
Because there's no problem.
We don't know what's the way.
Not yet. That's what I was waiting. See, we were going to actually try and do something this week, but the board was not, you know, set up things, and you can't have it like at the last second. So Kathy is going to do flyers, and then we'll put that out, and then everybody here is to give the word out now. From here henceforth, let the word go forth.
Who's the setup committee?
The setup committee will be all of us, because it's really simple. We push these chairs away, get that out of the way, and Gary said he was going to do that, so I'll get with him. It's really not that.
Kevin will set up all of his equipment himself. So
how much is all soda?
Soda will be like $5.75. Oh, well, that's the question.
don't worry about that.
Well, how much cost on them? How much
even
are we going to charge for soda?
Don't worry about it.
No. How much are we going to charge for soda?
Just 50 cents.
We're
going to
make them pay.
75 is what's here.
Well, you should not make them pay. Give it to them.
We'll be paying $3 for the dance.
$3.
Well, that's what I'm saying. That's what we need to know.
We can give it to them. What's a bottle of soda?
That's not a good idea.
Why?
Because you'll probably have people.
Well, one, because if you just have the soda free, you'll have guys throwing soda all over the place. If they pay for it, they'll drink it.
Yeah.
Okay. Even if it's 50 cents. Okay. Excuse me, just
Another thing, wait a minute. I will, Monday when I go at the intergroup, I'm going to buy 10 big books. And do we have anything in common? I like to buy maybe 6 books, The Language of the Heart.
Yep.
Because a lot of people like to give that for Christmas.
Yes.
And should I buy 10? Whatever you say, it's okay with
Fine.
Me. And if we don't have any more money, I'll pay it and I'll take it.
You want to get
10? 10 Language of the Heart, that's $10 each. The big book is down to $5. It used to be 6, so they went down.
You can eat 10 Language of
the Heart? A lot of people give that
motion
for Christmas.
For 10, yes?
Yeah, that's a very important book to have.
A motion for 10?
That's $100.
Make 7 motion for 10.
That's $100 for 10 Language of the Heart, and I will buy 10, that's $50, so we got $200, but I will pay it in my money, and I'll bring the receipt, and I'll collect myself. Is that okay with the group?
Yes.
Why don't I get 5 Languages of the Heart? Why
don't
you get 10?
I like to get 7. Okay, 5. I'll buy 5 for me then. Because I like to give whatever the group say. 5?
Yes.
5, is it 5? 5 Languages of the Heart?
Did you don't forget 1 Language of the Heart?
Are they 7?
Well, I'll put you separate.
You like
7. Okay, 6 and 5. 6 and 5.
Do we get a cost on the soda waters?
No.
50 cents?
50 cents.
50 cents.
50 cents. Chips or anything like that? Do we want that?
What standard?
Normally, now a lot of the other dances, they sell hot dogs and stuff like that. If there were people who wanted to get involved in that, I'd rather not. If they want food, let them go out because it's a pain in the derriere. That's between your midsection and your...
Why don't we just
grab
one and see how it goes?
If someone wants to bring
should I buy a lot of $1, $2 chip also? We got a lot of people who celebrate 1 and 2.
Does anybody think?
Yeah, I believe I'm into a lot of dances. There's like big bowls and chips and stuff.
You want to do that?
Yeah,
that's good. I'll just chips and pretzels, things like that. Do you want to buy that? We'll get some of that and just leave it out.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Any motion? Kathy?
I'm
sorry.
Oh,
go ahead.
Are we going to have this every week or every other week?
Right now, the first one, and then we can see what we do. If we want it the next week, we can have it. You know, if we can say, yes, we're going to have it. What do you think, Jim?
Well, I think there's no reason not to do it every week if we've got the...
Well, you're running into Christmas, Jim. You're going to have a problem at Christmas time with other parties.
Are they going to raise our rent?
No. Oh, that's the other thing about the dance. If we go ahead and donate the proceeds to the dance, there is no extra charge to the group for the hall.
Oh, good.
That's what I was told so far.
Okay. I'll bring the bristle.
Okay, now we can, which I would suggest, make a specific donation of like $50 so we're covered at each dance. But once we get the money, let's see where we're at. Most of the dances don't make all that much. So.
This isn't for a purpose of making money.
I understand that, but I'm talking about over cost. I understand that, Jim.
Well,
We got plenty.
But that's not what
there's no problem.
Asking.
Yeah.
I think we need to have something that people can count on, that they can plan their Saturdays to be here.
Okay.
They have a step meeting, and they have a tradition meeting, and they have a dance, and that takes care of planning for Saturday. The social stuff, and the tradition stuff, and the recovery stuff, it's all in one package. That's the way I visualize it anyway. I think we'll attract people from all over for this.
Do we want it every week?
Yes.
There's another thing also, instead of giving general service $50 all the time, we can give half and give half to the club.
Well, we're not going to give them anything more than they have asked for. Why would we want to give them any more money?
To who?
The club.
Well, the club, because we got it till 1 o'clock in the morning.
They're getting all of the gate. All the donations are going to them. They're going to get paid.
Okay.
Yeah. So until further notice, it's every week.
Yeah.
That's what I wanted to know.
That's what we're going to do. We'll see how it works out. It may not pan out.
Okay.
This is an experiment. Yeah.
I have a question. Okay. I'm home. Question for he mentioned about we're going to have snacks that he's going to supply snacks.
I want to know what we want first. That's
Well, what I was going to suggest was anyone that wants to donate. Like sandwiches or salads and stuff. Why can't you just do that?
You can if you
want to
bring it.
Sure, of course. Absolutely.
But the club should just supply chips and shit.
Right.
Yeah. One thing we need.
No, what I'm saying, like if I want to make a salad, potato salad or something,
right? Yeah, bring whatever you want.
Tom, do you have a cash box?
Yes.
Okay. We need somebody to handle.
Kathy.
Okay, good. It's
and
all set up.
Bob Lines will be here from the club for the first dance. See, okay. Here's the thing we have with the every week thing. Is that up until now, they've had a board member here every week. We do not have a board member here. We have members, but not board members. By the way, how many here are, there's a big difference. Board members are the people that are like over the whole club. Mm-hmm. And members are people who join the club. How many here are club members? I know Jim is.
You're not a member of the club. Okay, I want to thank all for being here. We really don't have time now to get into tradition. I apologize for that, but I want to be able to give full measure to the second tradition. So we'll get to that next week. I want to thank all of you for being here and participating in our business meeting. We got a lot accomplished. Thank you, Tom, and thank you, Janine. You do a wonderful job.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank all of you guys, and I'll see you next week.
Yeah, I'm tired.
I've been doing nothing.
I